before you on tonight, amen. Today is a real spot. Glory to God. Remember, God loves the Lord. We're going to be all back, please. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Give it up to the pastor of the house. Amen. It's a privilege that he allowed me to come forward to my sister who invited me, glory to God, on tonight. Amen. I don't have 3 points in the subject on tonight. I basically have a testimony, amen, of the word of God and how it has played in my life. Hallelujah. I'm only 29 years old, glory to God. Hallelujah. And I can think back on a time where on this Saturday night, I would be getting rest to get ready to go to the club. Now, the thing is, glory to God, I would be a Christian, or I'll say a churchgoer, because that next Sunday morning, hallelujah, you could find me in the church, hallelujah, up on the drums. But something about that just didn't mix, glory to God, in the year of 2008, hallelujah. I encountered this young man, hallelujah, who told me about the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And see, as I said, I grew up in the church, like many of you, amen. Particularly, we're talking about the young folk, but there are some older folk who need to hear this as well. Hallelujah. You've been made to go to church in your youth days, in your youthful days. It's not something that you desire to do, but you're made to do. And the thing is, as I said earlier, glory to God, you have to have a relationship with Jesus Christ to truly know why you need to be in the house of God. Hallelujah. We thank God for those parents who raise the children. The Bible says to raise your children up in the way that they must go, so when they get old, they will not depart from him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So continue to bring your children in the house of the Lord. And see, the thing is, amen, I'm a person who, when I was doing my dirt, I was good with it. Nobody really knew about it. You know, and glory to God. I hid it good for my grandmother. The people in the church didn't know nothing about it. I had my own lifestyle, Monday through Friday, glory to God. Doing whatever I wanted to do. I said Monday through Saturday. And when it came time to come into the house of God, oh, I was on the drums, faithful Sunday school cover, perfect attendance, 3 years in a row. But here I am, in the club, listening to music that was contrary to the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I was a Sunday school teacher, and I was still out fornicating. A Sunday school teacher, and still hanging out with people that did me no good. Listen to me, young people. I'm only 29 years old, hallelujah. The Lord has done an awesome work. And I believe, glory to God, that he can do that same type of work in your life if you yield and surrender to him. I understand that this is a musical, and you find yourself in a position in the church where you're singing. You think that you're doing the will of God. Now, I'm not saying that you don't need to be in the house of God doing these things if you're not saved. Hallelujah. But it becomes a point where it is vanity when you're not saved. Okay. The enemy can have you in the house of God all your life. And that's why I say there's some older folk in the church who's not saved.
Amen.
Church goers. Okay. Church folk. Don't know the Lord as their Savior. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm not trying to step on anybody's toes. I'm just telling the truth as it is. Hallelujah. And as I was telling you, 2008, when this young man told me about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, that's when my life caught on fire for God. That's when my relationship with Jesus Christ began to get intimate. I began to see myself withdrawing from the sinful ways of the world, not because man was pulling me, but because the Spirit of God and the Word of God was drawing me. Thank you, Jesus. And I want to encourage some of you, hallelujah, because I believe that there's some of you who will, as soon as you leave this place, you get in your car and you turn on your world of music after having sung these songs of Zion. Okay, Rabbi C, Shalabba C, hallelujah. And you'll find nothing wrong with it because there's no conviction there. But I guarantee you, hallelujah, If you begin to take inventory of what's being said right now about your relationship with Jesus Christ and what he's done, when you come to know truly what he's done, I can probably ask him of you right now, how is it that you know that you're saved? And you wouldn't be able to give a legitimate reasoning how it is that you know that you're saved. Do you know how it is that you have been saved? Faith in Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus, or I say the Father, loved us so much. The Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's love. He gave his Son Jesus. Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. To wash you clean of your sins. So that you can have an intimate relationship with the Father. Because sin separates us from the Father. There is enmity between us when we don't know Jesus as our Lord and Savior. But Jesus shed blood on Calvary, paid that price so that we can be in right standing. And not only did he do that, but he sent the Holy Ghost. Now this is where a lot of people, my God,
amen,
you've not heard about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, oh, yes, with the evidence of speaking in tongues. The Bible says in Acts chapter 1 and 8, after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, you shall receive power. Glory to God. This is not just power to be a witness. This is power to live as a witness.
Hear me.
We were not called to be Christians and live according to our own power. That's why the Holy Spirit was sent. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says in Zechariah that it's not by power, nor by might, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So what are you talking about, Terrell? On the day of Pentecost, glory to God, in the book of Acts, chapter 2, when Jesus sent the promise of the Father, yes, he promised the Holy Ghost, in St. John, chapter 16, he said, I'll send you another comforter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. See, those disciples were walking with Jesus when he was on earth. And he gave them power to do what they needed. But when he left, hallelujah, he said, you're going to need some power. You're going to need some help. You're going to need a teacher. And see, the Holy Spirit is our teacher because he teaches us the things of God that the natural mind cannot perceive.
Praise
hallelujah.
God.
That's why there's so many carnal-minded Christians. Who don't see anything wrong with listening to worldly music and then turning around and singing songs that supposedly glorify the Lord and Savior Jesus. But hallelujah, the Holy Spirit, the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 2, amen. On the day of Pentecost, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit came in like a rushing mighty wind. And he sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gave them the utterance. Now, I grew up in a church where they didn't believe in the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Uh-oh. That's why I was living a life that was powerless, and I could not come into the full, hallelujah, conception of who Jesus was.
All right.
That's why I didn't have any convictions when I was in the club getting my dance, my freak on. Glory to God. That's why we go out 11 o'clock at night, go back in Sunday morning about 3 or 4 in the morning and get in the choir or the drums and play the drums and have no conviction. It was just something about, I'm just doing this. But after I got filled with the Holy Ghost and out by my safety, I'm a shadow. In March 2009, glory to God. And see, I was skeptical about the speaking in tongues part because it was something foreign to me. I never heard of it, but the Bible it clearly lets us know that that was the evidence when it got filled. First Corinthians lets us know, hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me hurry up, hallelujah, because I see some people getting weary in their eyes and their spirits. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But hallelujah, the Bible says, and we speaking tongues. Hallelujah. Nobody understands, but we're speaking unto God. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verses 2 and 4. Glory to God. We're not come to understand the most important thing is, glory to God, that with the baptism of the Holy Ghost, my relationship became more intimate. I became more sensitive to the things of God. Even in your young age, I don't care. I've seen testimonies of babies being filled with the Spirit. Hallelujah. And maturing on to be great persons in our lives. Hallelujah. I want you to take inventory right now. Hallelujah. Because see, you weren't expecting it tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But I believe that some of you in here tonight are not truly saved. You need to know Jesus as your Savior. And see, He loves you.
Yes.
He loves you. God is not an angry God like He used to be in the Old Testament. People, they got all these rules set out where you need to do this and you need to do that. Okay? But because of Jesus and His grace, and His
mercy,
Hallelujah. You can come as you are.
Hallelujah.
No matter what state you're in right now, I don't care what you're doing. I don't care what you may do when you leave out of the doors. Tonight is the night, glory to God, that you need to surrender your will.
Hallelujah.
For the Lord's will. Hallelujah. That it may be done in your life. And it begins with you surrendering and giving your life to Jesus.
Amen.
And see, the thing is, I told you about the baptism of the Holy Ghost. So not only can you be saved, but now you can have the power to live a life according to the will of God.
Praise God.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You see, I guess I need some people praying. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Not just the young people, but older as well. Not only that, have you received the baptism of the Holy Ghost in the evidence of speaking in tongues? God wants to do something for you tonight. Hallelujah. This is the beginning of a new year. And if you want to see Jesus on another level, I believe tonight is your night. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. If you truly want to come into the understanding of the songs that you sing unto Jesus Christ, all of the youth, if you're under 35, if you're under 35, I want everybody to come out. Thank you. the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Encouragement that has gone forth on today. We believe, oh God, that as these young people, oh God, have heard your word go forth in testimony, that they will begin to spark up a new desire, a new hunger, and a new thirst for you, Jesus. That they may come to know you, Lord Jesus, on a more intimate level, oh God. Lord Jesus, we know that it's all about you and it's not about us. And on tonight, we believe on tonight, oh God, thank you, Jesus, that there has been a breaking in some of their minds and spirits, oh God, that they will get to surrender to you and that I say yes to Jesus, hallelujah, that they'll say yes to you, Lord, hallelujah, their young ages, oh God. I believe, oh God, and I know that you have a purpose for each and every one of these persons on tonight. Hallelujah. And I believe that you will begin to reveal your purpose to these people. And they sing songs tonight. And they sing songs tonight. Begin to move in their hearts. Begin to move in their hearts, oh God. Like never before, oh God. Let the fire of God fall fresh from heaven. Hallelujah.
Oops.